the business is called Bed Bath & Beyond, but there were a number of other companies that existed under that parent company. How and why did decide to get rid of some of those assets?
Well, I think that we were very diversified in terms of our overall assets, 8 to 9 companies, all operating separately, using some platforms that were similar, but mostly different. It was really, you know, a diversification of our time, our capital, our energy, sitting down strategically saying, what is an ecosystem of brands and businesses that we can use in terms of data and operations to create synergy, create growth, and really fuel the customer experience? So thinking for us originally around our strategy around the all-important life moments, our goal is to be dominant force in everybody's life in those key life moments, whether it's going back to college, whether it's moving into your first apartment with friends, whether it's, you know, buying your first home, meeting your partner, getting married, having children, in whatever order you choose, downsizing, then taking your kids to college. I mean, it's almost like the circle of life. And when we looked at that and the companies that we had in our mix, some of those were very, very squarely in that space, and others were a little superfluous and they weren't performing as well. And so we're like, let's pare this down to this core synergistic group that we can drive our core business, connect with customers, use data and engagement in a different way. And so no small feat over the period of COVID, we divested of 5 companies. That divests not only of the asset, but also the time and energy, and also invests in the cash to fuel and generate the growth in the core 4. So now we're left with Bed Bath & Beyond, Bye Bye Baby, Harmon and Decorist, all building together to build this ecosystem of strength for life moments.